Hey guys, today I want to talk to you about what I call a tight bully, a tight bulldog. And I've got my very well paid model here, DSK's Apollo, to help me with this. You see, 100 years ago, guys, in the early development stages of the English bulldog, they didn't look exactly like they do today. Back then, English bulldogs had wrinkle, but not near as much wrinkle as the bulldogs of today have. They had short muzzles, but not nearly as short and smashed of a muzzle that they do today. They had tighter coats. So let's talk about a tight bulldog, because as time went on, what we saw as extremities in the bulldogs, extremely short muzzle, extremely wrinkled, it just continued to increase. If a little wrinkle was good, a lot of wrinkle was better. If a little bit of a pudgy body type was good, a lot of pudginess was better. And in that process, these bulldogs became less and less functional. That has become a problem. And that is not what I particularly like in a bulldog. So I'm going to share some of my philosophy and how to have a good bulldog that's comfortable and serves his family well, even as just a companion, and also doesn't cost as much. So let's talk about the concept of a tight bulldog, and we're going to start from the ground up with Apollo. Check out his feet. He has what I call cat paws. Cat paws are tight paws as opposed to splayed paws, where like when he stands, his foot just spreads out. He has cat paws. And I know you can probably hear that heavy breathing in the microphone there. I apologize for that. But we want a bulldog with tight, cat-like paws, guys. Secondly, what about his skin? See, take a look at his skin. He has a tight skin to him. It's not got a lot of looseness. It doesn't have a lot of wrinkles to it. So I like a tight skin. The third thing on a tight bulldog that I like is the coat. That big, heavy coat on a bulldog, if it's indoors, which most of our bulldogs are indoors, it's twice the shedding of a tighter coat. I like the tight coat also because picture a bodybuilder walking around with a heavy winter coat. You can't see his muscles. He can't display his definition and his muscle mass. But that same bodybuilder in a tight t-shirt, you see all the muscle. And we all know that I like muscle on my bulldogs. And then finally, in a tight bully, a tight bulldog, I like a tight face, guys. If you have a lot of looseness on a bulldog's face, you tend to be more prone to eye entropia, eye ailments, okay? If you've got a lot of looseness around the muzzle, the nose, you've got wrinkles. Those things are a hygiene issue as well as a health issue. It's a high maintenance issue for you and your bulldog. So I like just a tighter face also. And then finally, the last thing is what you can't see in a bulldog. It's his joints and his soft tissue. I like a tight bully that has tighter joints, not the loose joints. They move better. They function better. They're healthier. They're happier. Guys, thanks for your time and watching this. If it's brought value to you and you think that it would help somebody else, be sure to share it. Have a great day. Guys, thank you for tuning in to this segment of I Am Bulldog. I hope that it brought you and your bulldog value. If it did, please hit the like button below, and also feel free to share this video with your other bully friends. And if you really want to dig in and see more cool videos from the I Am Bulldog Nation, hit the subscribe button. Thanks, guys. Have a great day.